Today's topic, air pollution. You know, we keep hearing of the increasing levels of oxides of nitrogen and sulfur in news. And people always say, you know, the quality of air has been reduced. And whatever we used to observe during our childhood, now the quality of air is affected. And it's all because of the oxides of nitrogen and sulfur. What happened? Why is it so? It's all because of the burning of fossil fuels. We are quite familiar with coal, petroleum. These fossil fuels, know to some extent, they have nitrogen and sulfur. And when these are burnt, so these two are burnt, automatically it produces different oxides. Why? Because burning first is only taking place in the availability of oxygen. So whenever oxygen is provided, nitrogen and sulfur burns and it forms oxides of nitrogen and oxides of sulfur. Not only this, if we inhale these gases, these are dangerous. All right. Another aspect that we know is, whenever these dissolve in water, now these are the oxides of nitrogen and oxides of sulfur. These mix with water to form sulfuric acid and nitric acid. Clear? This is how these are dissolved in rain to give rise to acid rain. Aur kisko bolte hain acid rain? Isi ko hi to bolte hain. When these oxides are mixed with water and these fall down in the form of an acid and there is acidic formation in water, this acidic formation is sulfuric acid and nitric acid. And combustion of fossil fuels also increases. तो क्या होता है? पहला इफेक्ट इनहेलेशन में प्रॉब्लम, दूसरा इफेक्ट एसिड रेन फॉर्मेशन. हाउ दीज फॉसिल फ्यूल्स आर अदरवाइज डेंजरस, दे इंक्रीज द अमाउंट ऑफ सस्पेंडेड पार्टिकल्स इन एयर. अब क्या होगा? द थर्ड इफेक्ट, अनबर्नड कार्बन पार्टिकल्स विच आर सस्पेंडेड हियर एंड देयर, वी कॉल देम हाइड्रोकार्बन्स. एंड हाई लेवल ऑफ दीज हाइड्रोकार्बन्स means the suspended, unburnt particles, suspended unburnt particles, which could be unburnt carbon particles also, right? These lower down the visibility, especially in cold weather when the water condenses, and automatically these are also present there. It ultimately leads to the formation of smoke. Okay, so lowers visibility along with formation of smoke. That means smoke plus fog. Ek to wahan pe water vapors already dense hai, means fog condition. Along with these unburnt particles also gives an added advantage. To wo kya ho gaya? Smoke. And regularly breathing air which contains all these substances, it increases the incidence of allergy, cancer, heart disease. So these pollutants in air, it forms air pollution. This air pollution, which is increasing day by day, is only because of the vehicular pollution, because of the factories which run and emitting enormous amount of smoke, because of the unburnt hydrogen carbon particles, and formation of smog, acid rain, oxides or pollutants in air causing havoc, and absorbing them, then causing allergies and health problems to ourselves because of in this environment, is becoming another factor in decreasing or deteriorating health these days. Fine. Now moving to water. When we talk about water, We know water is a wonderful liquid.
Why?
Because it has the capacity to dissolve everything whatever comes across. Its availability is also wonderful. Some of it is found underground. One source is underground. It is also in the form of water vapors in the atmosphere. Right? Fresh water is also found frozen in the ice caps at the polar areas. There we find fresh water. Again, it is also available in sea, ocean, right? Here, the amount of water which is there, it has more amount of salt added into it and we call it saline water. Then, it is also in river, lakes, ponds. So availability of water, fresh water, it varies from place to place. Practically every summer, most places have to face shortage of water. We know that. And in rural areas where the supply is not been installed properly, people have to, you know, move to various far off areas and sources to fetch water. This is a condition. Now, why this water is so important? The necessity. So this importance lies in a fact that all the organisms, they need water, because all the cellular processes, these takes place in water medium only. That means all the reactions which are taking place in our body, these take place in water medium, as these substances are dissolved in water. It means if the substances have to dissolve, that needs water. If substances have to be transported from one place to another, that also requires water. And ultimately, organisms need to maintain a little amount of water in their body. Why? To stay alive. And terrestrial life forms, it requires fresh water because their bodies cannot tolerate to get rid of high amount of dissolved water, and salts need to be easily released from the body. So accessibility is, we have to have water in the body for taking up various reactions, for dissolving certain substances, for transporting certain substances, as well as to survive on land. Right? Now, how do we get to know that it is really affecting the lifestyle of all the living beings? If we compare a patch of land before rainfall and after rainfall, and we compare vegetation at an area which is regularly watered compared to the barren land, automatically the availability of water will tell us that more vegetation will be found in a rain-fed area or which is regularly watered compared to a dry patch. Ultimately, the growth of living organisms in that area determines that yes, life requires, or water is required for life, to maintain life, to be alive. Right? Now we come to the topic, if water is available, there will be pollution also. Like if air is there, there is air pollution. Same way, wherever there is water pollution. What kind of water pollution are we talking about? We are talking about the dissolved pesticides, insecticides, chemicals, and other agents. Right? Pehla point toh humara fertilizers ka hoga. fertilizers and pesticides, which are dissolved in water, which are used in our farms. Some percentage of that is washed into the water. Always. Then second is the sewage. Sewage from where? Sewage from our homes, our towns and cities, factories, everywhere. It is dumped into rivers and lakes. Specific industries also use water for cooling, for various operations, and ultimately what do? They return hot water into the water bodies. When this temperature range is changed, then the level of the water is also affected along with the flora and fauna which is there in the underground zone of that water resource or water body. That is also affected. So change in temperature of water, water temperature affect flora and fauna. Flora, all the plantae, fauna, all the living animal creatures. Now, water inside the deep reservoir would be colder than the water at the surface, which gets heated up by the sun. So this all affects the life forms that are found in these water bodies in various ways. It can encourage the growth of some life forms and harm other life forms. So generally we have to maintain a balance between various organisms. They have to maintain a balance to combat this water pollution. What are the following effects and what are the use of this? You know, water pollution is never useful, but yes, it has drastically affected. How? The effects are, first of all, the addition of undesirable substances into the water bodies. These could be, as we have discussed above, fertilizers and pesticides. Undesirable substances. Children, how can we forget the death of so many fishes in the lakes these days due to this plastic and other, you know, non-biodegradable substances? It has reduced flora and fauna to such an extent that water bodies are almost getting over, and fishes, other living creatures, are at the verge of extinction just because of this addition of all these non-biological agents. Now, addition of undesirable substances into the water bodies. These substances could be the fertilizers, could be the pesticides which are used, and could be the poisonous substances as well. So fertilizers, pesticides, and poisonous substances. These poisonous ones These are mercury salts, which are used in the paper industry, and these could also be the disease-causing organisms like the bacteria which cause cholera and disease-causing organisms to which we call pathogens. Second factor is the removal of desirable substances from the water bodies, means dissolved oxygen is used by the plants and animals that live in water. So is point ke andar hum kya karte hain? Hum karte hain BOD, biochemical oxygen demand. Kya hota hai ye biochemical oxygen demand? Every living creature needs oxygen supply for its survival, and any change that reduces the amount of dissolved oxygen affect these aquatic organisms, and other nutrients could also be depleted from the water bodies. Supposingly, we are adding more and more amount of sewage or more debris. Let's do it in this one. This is the dissolved oxygen. These are the debris. Initially, the amount of oxygen was high and the amount of debris was low. as this amount keeps on increasing, this will keep on decreasing. Fine. More and more debris will lead to depletion of oxygen, dissolved oxygen from the water body. What will happen? The symbiotic bacteria or the aerobic bacteria, which require oxygen to clear debris, will not function properly, because the amount of debris is increased now and the amount of dissolved oxygen has decreased now. Since it is decreasing, these aerobic bacteria will not function properly to clear off all the debris from this water body. And what will happen? These aerobic bacteria will show biochemical oxygen demand, BOD, that we need to supply oxygen into this water body. How that can be done? Supplying oxygen is not possible. Then how can that be done? By reducing the amount of debris from that bacteria. We can easily clear off debris, and ultimately the amount of debris tells us about the condition of the water body. The amount of biochemical oxygen demand will tell us about the amount of debris present in the water body. It's vice versa. Okay, more is the debris, more is the biochemical oxygen demand, and less is the oxygen availability. So if this is more, this is less. If this is less, automatically the debris content in the water body is much, much more. Clear? Then, third point, if we clear that the amount of temperature range in the water body, this is the C point, that is the temperature variation. If we check the temperature variation, we can say that aquatic organisms are used to a certain range of temperature in the water body. ऐसा नहीं होता, हम लोगों का temperature zone है 25 degree Celsius पे, हम अपने आप को easily comfortable zone में रखते हैं that we can work. ऐसे ही हर एक species का temperature zone होता है, and below and above that range, species will not work comfortably. Same way, if in a water body where they live, there is a sudden marked change in the temperature, that would be dangerous for them to affect their breeding. Means the eggs and larvae of various organisms or animals, they are susceptible to temperature changes. Fine. Thinning of the eggshell is one such remarkable thing that is observed. So eggshell becomes thin, and premature rupturing of the egg releasing to the larvae or the babies ultimately decline the population of that particular species in that water body. So this is what we are talking about in water pollution.